Legislative IQ. Increase your legislative intelligence with Florida's policy, budget, and campaign monitoring service. Subscribe today at legislativeiq.com.
Lawmakers have yet to agree on how to spend more than $700 million they have to work with under the voter-approved Amendment 1. A big difference? Whether or not to invest the money in long-term bonds. Environmentalists think it's a good idea.
Voters, when they approved Amendment 1, they approved using the Amendment 1 dollars to pay the debt service on bonds. So that's the smartest way to get the money for Springs and Everglades and for the parks that we need.
The Florida House is on board, but the Senate is opposed. Senate Budget Chief Tom Lee says it's hypocritical for the House to reject federal money for health care, but then want to bond environmental money.
That for whatever reason, there is a preponderance of the members of the legislature that didn't want to draw down federal money to ameliorate the problems we have in our budget, but they want to whip out a credit card conveniently and blow a lot of money in the environment.
Because the House and Senate can't seem to come to an agreement, both chambers' budget chairmen will have the ultimate decision. The Everglades Trust, which wants to use Amendment 1 money to buy U.S. sugar land around the Glades, has launched attack ads on lawmakers they claim aren't doing enough. Senator Joe Negron wants to bond around $40 million for Everglades purchases.
I think it's appropriate, given the language in Amendment 1, that we use financing to make some environmental land purchases.
Whatever the outcome, environmentalists agree on one thing. Lawmakers are only spending a fraction of what they should be spending to honor the will of the voters. Reporting in Tallahassee, I'm Matt Gelka.